Good morning all of you. Today this video is going to be my fourth video on the chapter Relation and Functions. In the last video, that means in the third video, if you remember, we have solved two maths on the basis of equivalence relations. As far as I remember, I have given one homework to be done. I hope all of you might have tried, but no issue if you did not try, even we shall solve here. Now today in this video, first we shall solve this homework. After that we'll get into the next topic, namely as functions. First let us solve this homework. Now look at the homework. Let R is the relations on the set L. What is L here? The set of all straight lines defined by R equal to A comma B such that H height to B. Height to B means it is perpendicular. For all, AB belongs to L. Now, you have to check whether R is equivalence or not. The question is exactly same, like parallel. In the last video, the question was about parallel and this question is about perpendicular. That's why I have left this question as a homework. Because they are almost same. So, you have to explain in the similar manner. Okay, let us solve here again. First, we have to understand the R, how it is defined. What is told here? R equal to A comma B such that H height to B. That means R is the set of all ordered pairs of the form A comma B. How they are related? A and B? A and H height to B. If A and B are height, then A comma B belongs to R. Again, I am saying, if H height to B, then A comma B belongs to R. If H not height to B, then A comma B does not belong to R. So this line is very, very important to understand. As I told earlier, if by somehow you understand this line, then the math will be finished by 50%. So now let us check whether it is symmetric or not, reflexive or not, tangential or not. So let us check now. First, let us check how the R is defined. R equal to A comma B such that H height to B. For all, A comma B are coming from go down L. First, let us check the reflexivity. We know to be reflexive, we need to pick up a single element. So, let us pick up a single element from the given set L. We know any line, a line cannot be height to itself. A line cannot be height to itself. We know a line cannot be height to itself. So we can say the line A cannot be height to itself. एक लाइन खुद के ऊपर कभी हाइट नहीं होता, अंडरस्टैंड इट. सो ए लाइन कैन नॉट बी हाइट टू इटसेल्फ. सो वी कैन से ए इज नॉट हाइट टू ए. सो वी कैन क्लेम ए कॉमा ए डज नॉट बिलोंग्स टू आर. इट इज वायलेटिंग द डेफिनेशन ऑफ रिफ्लेक्सिव. सो वी कैन से आर इज नॉट रिफ्लेक्सिव. अंडरस्टूड और नॉट? Is not reflexive. Now let us come to symmetric. As you know, to be symmetric, first we need to pick up two distinct elements. So let us pick up, let AB belongs to L. At the same time, we assume that the order pair A comma B satisfying the given relation. It is already assumed. From here we have to check whether B comma A belongs to R or not. That is the story of symmetric. Now A comma B belongs to R means from the definition we can say A H height to B. For diagram, it is A, it is B. h height to b. Since h height to b, so reversely you can say also b will be height to a. From here you can say also b will be height to a. That means we can say by definition b comma a also belongs to R. So firstly we have assumed a comma b belongs to R. Now we have proved b comma a belongs to R. So we can say R is symmetric. Can I say or not? R will be symmetric. Now let us come to last point to check. Transitive. As we know, to be transitive we need to pick up three elements. So let us pick up three elements A, B, C from the given set L. So we have picked up three elements. At the same time we assume that the order pair A comma B satisfying the R as well as the order pair B comma C satisfying the R. We assume that since A comma B belongs to R, so we can claim A is height to B. Similarly, by the definition B comma C belongs to R means B is height to C. My ultimate target is here whether A comma C belongs to R or not. We have to check. Then it will be transitive. Since A comma B belongs to R, so A is height to B and B comma C belongs to R means B is height to C according to the definition. Now let us understand through the diagram. It is A. It is B. It is C. A is height to B here and B is height to C. Then tell me, what is the link between A and C? You say A is height to B and B is height to C. Now look at the diagram. So you can say A is not height to C. So you can say A is not height to C. In fact, they are parallel. In fact, A and C are parallel. So you can say from here A comma C does not belong to R. So here R is not transitive. So in this example we have proved it is not reflexive and it is not transitive, but it is symmetric. So it is the one example where it is neither reflexive or not transitive, but it is symmetric. But in the exam, in the CBC board exam, the question may be changed. They may ask you, give an example of equivalence relations where it is neither reflexive nor not transitive, but it is symmetric. So you have to produce this example. They may not ask you the direct questions. They may ask you the example. So you have to remember this example. Very, very good example. You have to remember. Understood? So if you have any doubt, any confusion about it, please comment on my video or contact me my personal WhatsApp. Understood? Now let us come to the next topic to be discussed, namely as functions. Already we got some ideas about the function in class 11. Let us recall again. What do you mean by function? We know function is nothing but a relations. It is a special type of relations. In elaborate way, suppose we are taking two sets A and B. Sets means A will contain some element and B will contain some element. That means from A to B we can get lot of relations. Among the all relations, we can get some special type of relations which will be satisfying the two particular conditions. From A to B, we can get lot of relations. Among the all relations, we can get some special type of relations which will be satisfying the two particular conditions. Those who will be satisfying these particular conditions will be as function. So among all the relations which will be satisfying these particular conditions will be known as function. So all relations are not function, but all function are relations. So you always have to remember this statement. All function are relations, but all relations are not function. Understood? Now let us come to what the condition was. The condition of getting function. For which conditions we can get a function from a relations? For which conditions a relation will become a function? Let us look at it. It is a set A, it is a set B. Every element of A has to be mapped with the element of B. That is the first condition. No one can escape. Every element of A has to be mapped with the element of B. No one can escape. Now, let us come to the second condition. Every element of A has to be mapped with the unique element of B, not more than one. Then it will be not function. Again, I am saying from the first, for which conditions a relation will become a function? The first condition is, every element of A has to be mapped with the element of B, compulsorily. No one can escape. Everybody has to participate in A. The second condition is that every element of A has to be mapped with the unique element of B, not more than one. So those relations will be satisfying these two particular conditions will become a function. So we can say all functions are relation, but all relations are not functions. So always you have to keep in mind. Understood? So we shall discuss about function elaborately in the next video. Today I stop here. Please be safe, be healthy, and please stay at the home. Thank you very much.